just pay attention. I don't know.
Yeah. I'm watching them right now. If they leave,
that was open. I don't know.
They just left. They just left. Follow.
Watch out.
Yeah.
Southwest.
Going left. I'm down. I'm gonna tunnel us in. Okay. Yeah.
They clean?
No. Right here. Follow. Oh, yeah.
Hey, open.
I'm gonna go now.
Should be fine. Hey, in this box. Wait.
Right here. Follow. Going down. Low ground. Alright. Hurt. Nice. Harpooning.
Yeah,
there's
boss.
Coming.
One shot.
Right here. Follow me. Crosshairs out. Do you need or no? Right here. Dead.
Nice. Popping minis.
I'm gonna flopper. I'm playing floppers. Going for height.
Play you.
There's someone else on height. Height is really high. Kill someone? I think I have height. Yeah, I do. I have height.
You're cracking up.
One shot.
A two? Oh, I died. Nice. Good shit. I'll put my body left. Oh, good shit.
Hey guys, it's Psychoma here, and welcome to this brand new series. This is the first episode of Road to Fortnite World Cup, where I keep you guys up to date on my progress and tips on how to improve, basically things that I'm going to use myself. The biggest problem that I see with tip videos on YouTube is things like 5 high ground retakes, or things of that nature, where really, things that you should be focusing on are rarely ever posted about. This series is going to be me documenting everything, including the practical things that I learn in scrims and VOD reviews. The goal of the series is to do everything necessary in order to qualify for Fortnite World Cup. If I can do that, that's when this series will come to an end, and you guys are coming along for the journey. First thing I'm going to do on this very first episode is rate myself currently out of 10 on game sense, mechanics, and aim, with the 10 being World Cup level. I give myself a 5 out of 10 on game sense. I think I do know the simple things that you need to do in a competitive lobby, but fundamentals like knowing how to impact frag and movings, high ground awareness, and circle 2 to 5 rotates are things that I need to work on desperately. These are definitely my weak points.
Get the zone here. Such a free rotate.
I give myself a 6 out of 10 on aim. I think my aim can be very good at times, but the main problem is how inconsistent it can be at times. Part of this can come from my lack of good mouse control, as I really have never played PC FPS games seriously, but I've been getting into Kovac's routine more and more to address this issue. I give myself an 8 out of 10 on mechanics. This is definitely where my strengths as a player lie, but I would be wrong to say that there aren't things I could improve at my mechanics. Watching people like Mr. Savage M, Moki, or Raider464 shows me how high the ceiling for mechanics can be, and there's always improvement to be had. Also, a subset of mechanics involves tunneling, which is very important in scrims, as we all know. And I always thought it was a simple thing to do, like just basic stair tunneling, like basic straight tunnels, but watching people like Bizzle and Lyrison tunnel shows me how well they understand character movement and player build range, something I could be adding to my own game. I think it's really important to always be evaluating yourself in these three areas to see where you should be focusing on. My focus needs to absolutely be on my aim and game sense, as the potential to improve there is the highest. They are definitely what hold me back in game, without a doubt. Tell me in the comments what you guys would rate yourself out of 10 in these three areas. Recently, I attended DreamHack Anaheim and competed at the Fortnite event there. The competition as a whole was very difficult, as top tier competitors from many different regions attended, and I didn't do too well myself. I placed around top 300 in both open heats, which requires top 200 to qualify to the next round, and I didn't even qualify out of the opens. It was my first big LAN, and I lacked the experience like the rest of the competitors necessary to play like I do at home. However, it wasn't only nerves. There was a ton of things about the game that I didn't fully understand that held me back. For one, understanding lines of sight better would help my rotates. I often left myself exposed on rotates that would get myself shot instead of using 10 or 20 wood to block an angle. Secondly, I really struggled to find impact frags in moving. I was able to get to endgame often, but finding that impact frag would have turned my endgames from a 20 to 25 point game into a 40, 50, 55 point game at DreamHack. Learning how to impact frag in moving zones is something that the top competitors know how to do very well. This is something that I lack and I need to work on. Thirdly, I really suck at fighting people one-on-one. When someone pushed me mid-game and I had no control and I had to fight them, I just shriveled up and died slowly because I just did not have the experience. I didn't fight many people in arena, as my main practice for DreamHack was zone rule customs, so the only fighting I had was really in endgame. I really think the remedy to this is watching strong WQers or fighters like Unknown and Kanata, and just spamming arena games and pushing everyone in my sight. Arena is a safe place to do this, and this is something that I'm lacking in my practice routine, and it showed at DreamHack. Despite my lackluster performance, the whole event was an amazing experience, both for meeting all the people in the scene and my own understanding of the game. I fully intend to look back at all the issues that held me back at this event and perform better at the next. One last thing I wanted to address before I close off this introductory episode is what I pride myself in, my mindset or my mentality. I cannot emphasize how important this becomes in any competitive sport. People talk about Kobe and how great he was at the sport, but forget all about his Mamba mentality. Everywhere I look, it just seems like the drive in the sport to practice and improve is just a defining factor to play well at any event. Imagine if Mr. Savage M listened to the opinions of the general public when Benji dropped him for Mongrel. What if he believed the opinions himself? Would he have won DreamHack? He ignored everyone and grinded and brought himself back to the top. This is a great example of a strong mentality. Lastly, everyone talks about VOD reviewing and how important it is for improvement. Something I want to talk about that goes hand in hand with that is accountability, or owning up to your mistakes to yourself. Not getting half-half zones or not pulling the correct gun from the chest and being headshot sniped by a person in 1 out of the 10 games in your cash cup is not the main reason why you can't perform. Understanding where you went wrong in-game and focusing on that is how you get accelerated improvement, and this shows in other sports as well. Anyways, that's it for the first introductory episode. The next video will definitely have more in-game related things. Most likely, it's going to be everything I know about fighting so far, a VOD review on Unknown, and what I'm learning by spamming a WP playstyle in Arena. But it will definitely keep you guys up to date on new things that I learned in Fortnite and where I stand in my goal to qualify for the World Cup. Be sure to subscribe to catch the next one, and I'll see you there.